Hey folks, Alex here from Extra Paycheck blog, and in this video I would like to show you the Bloom plugin that I'm using for my email marketing, for my opt-in forms to be more precise, on my website, on my blog. So what you see in front of you right now, this is the main window of the Bloom. That's how it looks within your WordPress installation. And as you see, I have some forms running at the moment. Some are active opt-in, some are inactive. And why I have an active, because I'm constantly testing and trying to see what works better and what doesn't. So here, as you can see, I have a pop-up. If we go to my site, this is the actual pop-up form that you see. This pop-up got over 1,000 impressions, 42 conversions at a 4.2% conversion rate, which is pretty low, but as I mentioned, I'm testing it. Still, I'm always going to be testing it and trying to see what works better. The very first pop-up that I did, which is inactive at the moment, got almost 5,000 impressions, 72 conversions at 1.4% conversion rate. So this one at 4.2% is already a lot higher. And this is what I mean by saying that testing is crucial. It's really, really important, and you could really increase your conversion rate by simply testing different opt-in windows and opt-in forms, if you want to call them that way. Now, another one at 0.3% conversion rate, which is extremely low, but I think in the situation that I'm using it, it's actually not that horrible. It's an inline opt-in form. Now, if I close this window right here, this is the one that you see right here. This is the inline form. I put it at the very bottom of my blog post, one of the blog posts. And see, this one gets a lot less attention than, let's say, a pop-up window. Okay, let's get back. I wanted to show you some of the more important things. Now, see, I've decided to actually deactivate an opt-in and create a new one in order to test it. However, you could simply create a second opt-in form by clicking on this button. It's called A/B testing, and Bloom, the plugin, will do the actual split testing for you, serving randomly one opt-in and then another opt-in, and it'll help you choose a winner, and it'll show you which one converts better than the other. Okay, so let's see how you create the actual opt-in within Bloom WordPress plugin. Create a new opt-in, and here you're going to choose one of the six types. So pop-up, fly-in, below post, inline, locked content, and the widget. If you're watching this video on YouTube and not on my blog, you could head over to extrapaycheckblog.com/bloom. This is where you'll be able to read more details and descriptions on these different sorts of opt-ins and how to use them. So yeah, once again, extrapaycheckblog.com/bloom. This is where I'll explain in details how I'm using it and why I'm using this specific opt-in. But now let's get going to the actual creation. So let's say we want to go with a pop-up. So you click on the pop-up form. It's starting to... This is the creation process, the setup process. So it's called my new opt-in. By default, let's leave it at that. I don't really care. As I mentioned, I'm using MailChimp. So let's select account MailChimp, email list, extra paycheck training. And now you go to the next step to design the opt-in. Now, designing the opt-in, first of all, you have lots of different choices of already pre-designed opt-ins. Opt-in forms. As you can see, there is a lot of them actually, and you can choose whichever one you like, whichever one you think would work better. And as I mentioned once before, or many times before, you could easily switch between designs. You could easily create a new form. It just takes a minute or so, so it's really easy. So let's just go with, I don't know, something bright. I wanted something bright. Let's use this green one, let's say. Okay, so we click on it, then scroll down, and then we're going to customize it. Okay, so this is the actual headline. So you create your headline. I'm gonna leave it all by default for the moment. Now you have the action opt-in message. You can modify it as well, and as you can see, you could change the colors of the text, you can bold it, center it, and a whole bunch of other things. Now the image that comes in with your opt-in form, you could upload your own image. You don't have to use what Bloom is already giving you, but I'm going to use it for now. Now you could choose the image load animation, slide up, slide down, slide right, bounce, whole bunch of different things. So just leave it at slide down or whatever it is. You can also hide this image on mobile devices, which I will check in. Because when it shows up on a mobile phone or on a tablet, this image takes up a lot of space. So we want to get rid of that. Now you could change the background color. See, there's a whole bunch of other things. You could choose a border, no border, full border. Now if you choose a full border, you could have different kinds of border. Let's choose this one. A whole bunch of different styling options available, and see, it's all at a click of a button. Form setup. You could choose where you want your form to be, on the left, on the right, at the bottom. Now you can choose here if you want the name to be required for the opt-in. Let's say single name field, first and last name as well. I'm going to choose let's say single name field. Usually I don't use a name, but you can do that. So here are the two fields that you see: name and email. Button text, subscribe. You can modify that as well. You could choose whatever text you want, something more of a, you know, get your free ebook or receive your discount today, whatever you want. So for the button, you could choose whatever you want. Now form styling, again, more styling for your form. Form edge styles, you can play with that. As I'm saying, there's just so many options, and they're so easy to use and so easy to modify, to select, to choose. Now form footer text, you could put some text in there. You could also add custom CSS if you're comfortable with that. I'm not, so I'm not going to mess around with the CSS. Next step, display settings. Now this is an interesting one. And wow, again, a lot of settings to make your forms and your website really personalized. So you can make it fade in or slide or zoom or flip or bounce and so many other things. Let's leave it at fade in. Trigger after time delay. You can select that or not select that. So let's say I'm going to leave it at that, trigger after time delay, and I'm going to type in 5 seconds. So I want my opt-in to show up after 5 seconds of the visit. As you can see, there's many other options. You could trigger it after inactivity, and you could decide how long the user is inactive on your site in order to see your opt-in form. You could trigger it once the user reaches the end of your post. Trigger after commenting, trigger after scrolling, trigger after purchase. You could choose how many times per session your visitor is going to see this opt-in form. So let's say once per se- if you choose once per session, then it's going to appear only once on one post for your user. I think it's, honestly, I'm not sure. I don't remember what kind of delay. Okay, so here it is. Session duration in days. So 1 day. So you could set it to show only once per day for every user. So, you know, they don't get to see your opt-in form if they go to several pages of your website, which also could be annoying. So it's actually, I think it's better to limit it to, let's say, one display once per session. But I'm not going to do it now. Hide on mobile. You could also hide the whole pop-up completely if someone accesses your site from a mobile device. Display on. Here's you decide where it's going to be displayed. You could display completely everywhere on your website, or you could choose homepage, archives, category, tags, posts, pages, and projects. And you know, you don't have to choose just one. You could choose a few different ones. So let's say on posts and on pages and on homepage, right? This is where this specific pop-up is going to show. Now categories, you could unselect or select specific categories where you want it to show. Do not display on these pages. So let's say you set it to display on pages, but you don't want it to be displayed on a specific page. You just type in the name of the page in here, and it's not going to display. So all these different settings once again. And finally, we'll go to save and exit. And here you go. This is the new pop-up that we see it right here. So now let's refresh the site and see if I get to see it actually. Oh, there you go. Right away, we see it appear. This is all the default settings that I didn't change. The headline, the text. You can see I have the name and the email field, subscribe button. Well, that's pretty much it. So it's working. It's in front of you. This is how easy it is to set up a form with Bloom. Once again, I love it totally, mostly because I could track the conversion rate and I could easily change the settings. And if you go right here on this little button, you could actually change the existing form, the one that we just created. Here, let's see, you could go into design and change to whatever you want. Display settings, change to whatever you want. So you don't have to create a new one. Let's say if you just want to add a few light modifications to your existing form, you just go into that form and you modify it. That's pretty much it. So really awesome plugin. I recommend it highly if you're doing email marketing with your website. And I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching.